Shalom and welcome. I'm Pastor Bruce Dowell, Senior Pastor of Shiloh Messianic Congregation, located here in Southern California. I'm glad that you're checking out our website today, and I just want to give you permission to just take all the time you need, check out every page, and I also want to encourage you to contact us with any questions, comments, or thoughts that you might have. And I want to invite you back often. We're trying to keep the website updated, to keep it very regular. And so come and check these updates. Now, since you're on the Passover page right now, I'm going to go ahead and take a few minutes, and I want to ask four questions, and I want to give four answers to those questions. This will be in regards to Passover. And it's just an overview of the Feast of Passover, but I think it'll help give some understanding so you can have an appreciation. The question number one was this: what is Passover and why should we celebrate it? Well, first of all, it's a commanded Moedim. I want you to turn your Bibles, if you have your Bibles, to Vayikra, that's Leviticus 23, verse 1 and 2. And Leviticus 23, 1 and 2 says this: Adonai said to Moshe, tell the people of Israel the designated times of Adonai, which you are to proclaim as holy convocations, are my designated times. Now, what's interesting here is this word that is in your English Bible as designated is the word Moedim. It literally means an appointment that's been set by God. So God has shared with his people appointed times and told us, I've got an appointment with you. I want you to be there. That word convocation, on the other hand, is the word mikra. And the word mikra literally means rehearsals. So what the Lord is telling us in these passages in Leviticus is this: he has appointed times for us to come together with one another and with him. And at these appointed times, he wants each one of us to rehearse these special times and these special festivals. Now, if we jump down into verse 5, same chapter, here's what we read. In the first month, on the 14th day of the month, between sundown and complete darkness, comes Pesach for Adonai. Pesach for Adonai. Now, I don't know if you picked up on it or not, but each one of these Moedim, each one of these appointed times, are, we are told that they are God's appointed times. These are not festivals of the Jews. These are not inventions of the Jews. These are appointed times that God has given to us, his people. So if you are his people, these appointed times are for you. So the answer to question number one is, what is Passover? It is an appointed time that God has established with his people, and he has given us instructions to rehearse at this time, and he's told us to do this for all generations. Jump down in verse 14 of Vayikra 23. Verse 14 says this: you are not to eat bread, dried grain, or fresh grain until the day you bring the offering for your God. This is a permanent regulation through all your generations, no matter where you live. So we find out that this is appointed by God, and we need to do this wherever we live until the Lord says stop. Now, the second question that I want to ask is this: what is the history or the historical significance of Passover, and why should we observe Passover rather than Easter? It's a good question. Let me begin by saying the roots of Easter began in paganism. This is a historical fact, and we know also that throughout history, Easter has been associated with the worship of the goddess of fertility, hence the eggs and the bunnies. We know that Easter dates all the way back to Babylon. Passover, on the other hand, Passover's roots were never anything but biblical. They were commanded by God some 3,500 years ago. In fact, Passover is mentioned 74 times in the Bible. 47 times in the Tanakh, that's the Old Testament, and 27 times in the Brit Hadashah, that's the New Testament. The Bible never mentions Easter in the original manuscripts. Never mentions Easter. Can you imagine that? Also, Yeshua, Jesus, his disciples, the Apostle Paul, all celebrated Passover and encouraged and commanded us to do the same. Celebrate Passover, keep Passover, not Easter. I want you to turn to 1 Corinthians 5:7. 1 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 7, and here's what it says. Rabbi Shaul, Paul is writing to us, and he says, get rid of the old hametz. That's the hametz is the leaven, so that you can be a new batch of dough, because in reality, you are unleavened. For our Pesach lamb, the Messiah, has been sacrificed. So let us celebrate the Seder, not with leftover hametz, the hametz of wickedness and evil, but with the matzah of purity and truth. So Paul refers to Yeshua in this scripture as the Passover lamb. So when we compare the roots of Passover with the roots of Easter, what we quickly discern and what we quickly pick up on is this is a contest, a spiritual contest, between the goddess of fertility and the God of Israel. Now, the third question that I want to ask today is this. Do we see Yeshua in the Passover? Well, we get the answer from the book of Shemot, that's Exodus chapter 12. Now, I'm not going to read this whole chapter for sake of time, but you can read it on your own. It's verses 1 through 12, and I will just make reference to the individual verses and how they bring out Yeshua and the importance of the Messiah to us. In verse 2 of this chapter, chapter 12, we're told that the calendar changes. The Lord speaks to Moshe and he says, the calendar will begin this day. He says, in fact, the new year will begin on this day. So the calendar changes. Just like when we receive Yeshua, everything in our life changes and begins fresh, starts new. In verse 5, we read that the lamb was hidden. They would bring the lamb into their homes and hide it away. And as they were hiding this lamb away, this is symbolic of the fact that Yeshua has been hidden from the Jews for over 2,000 years as being the true Messiah. And of course, he's been hidden from us, Gentile believers, in the fact that he is the Passover lamb. So he was hidden. Again, in verse 5, we're told that the lamb was inspected. And if you'll remember the story, Pontius Pilate, after inspecting and quizzing and drilling Yeshua, Jesus, he comes back to the people and he says, I find no fault with this man. I find no error, nothing wrong. He had been inspected, definitely, by Pontius Pilate. In verse 6, we're told that the entire assembly kills the lamb, singular. So the entire assembly, although they would each kill a lamb, Each family would kill their own lamb, but in the Passover, as the lamb was killed, it was said that the whole assembly killed it as singular, the entire assembly. And this is important because Yeshua, the Passover lamb, died for my sins, for your sins, for all of our sins. So we are the reason this Passover lamb died. In verse 10, we're told that the lamb was skewed. What this means is after the lamb was killed, his chest was cut open and spread, and there was a stick put from throat to bottom to hold it open so it would roast, and then another stick was put from arm to arm to hold the arms outspread. In this, of course, we see a clear picture of Yeshua hanging on the cross. In verse 7, the blood was applied to the door. Okay? And of course, as believers in Yeshua, we know that the Passover lamb's blood has been applied to our lives, and because of that, that spiritual angel of death passes over us, and we who know the Messiah are in no fear of spiritual death whatsoever. And in verse 14, we're told that this is a perpetual regulation. Perpetual means it's an eternal regulation. It's going to go on. We know that heaven and earth are going to pass away, but God's word will never pass. So the answer to the third question is this: Passover is all about Yeshua. The fourth and the last question that I want to ask today is this: how do we celebrate the Passover? The answer is this: as Jeremiah 6:16 states, we keep it in the time and honored tradition of the ancient paths. We hold a Seder. The word Seder in the Hebrew language literally means the order of, so to set something in order. So at this Seder, what we do is we remember God's deliverance from bondage and slavery in Egypt. We remember how God took the people out of Egypt and he led them on the Exodus. We remember that Yeshua is God's deliverance for us, that we were covered by his blood. We remember that Yeshua is the Passover lamb that takes away the sin of the world. And so what we see in this, as we rehearse this story, remember that word rehearsal, we're to rehearse. So as we rehearse this story over and over, we see Yeshua in the entire story. Now in conclusion, the Bible teaches Passover and not Easter. Yeshua and his disciples participated in Passover. And the Bible tells us that the Passover celebration is perpetual. It's for all generations. It's forever. Now, I want to thank you for tuning in today. And if there's anything we can do to help you in your spiritual walk, feel free to call us or contact us. The information is on our website. And I just want to end by saying, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord lift up his countenance upon you and give you shalom.